So next thing is to unplug all the injectors so it doesn't fire. It will be just cranking so oil can climb up to the... but that's fairly easy to do. Basically, you just lift it and that unplugs, lift and unplug. Basically, it's lift here and you just unplug it. And this last one is basically a squeeze at the top, and you kind of remove it. So four removed, so I can crank it now. So that was roughly about 8-10 seconds of cranking, so to kind of get a bit of oil pressure. Next is to connect the injectors and to actually start it up. Okay, so I'm recording this in about 3 months after I've replaced the turbo, so I know really everything works quite correctly. One thing I need to say is this is supposed to be, so I've packed everything together, I've put an oil catch can, or I've put a second oil catch can here. But the oil feed in the banjo boat, the top banjo boat, as I was saying, you put, I can't quite remember, 27 or 70 millimeters and a half, and you torque this bolt 30 newton meters. Well, I did that, but then it was, I'm trying to show it, so it was seeping a bit of oil here. If you can go back to the video and see the photo there. So this was slightly touching the sides. This pipe was touching slightly the side. It was weeping like a drop or two from down the side here. So I backed off only slightly, so it's not really 30 newton meters, probably about 20 or 15 newton meters, but now it's doesn't touch any of the sides and doesn't weep any oil, so I've really relaxed it a bit, so it doesn't need to be really 30 newton meters, so it works absolutely fine. So if you see that this is weeping a bit of oil, just ease it off slightly, don't really need to do 30 newton meters. It would be good if you can do. So I suspect that the oil feed was slightly misshapen, so it maybe needs a bit of a kink here and there, so in order to that to be actually quite good. The second thing I need to say was when I started up the car, it was really rough. The engine sounded really rough. It was like I was afraid that the turbo and all was like, haven't done something correctly. But I suspect that the oil filter was brand new, and I also had replaced the sump as well. I'll have a video on that, how to replace the sump on these engines later on. So it just, the pickup, I had cleaned the oil pickup, so there wasn't enough oil picking up, so it needed a bit of time. But after like 5-10 minutes of running, it really became smooth as hell. So here is a video of the first the blue smoke of the first startup. You can see it quite here. So that one, there was quite a bit of smoke, and after about a month or so, I mean, this was a COVID lockdown, so after about a month or so, I didn't really drive it that much. I drove it every couple of days just to keep the battery topped up, but this is how it looked like, the smoke, really, after 2 months of running with a turbo. So as you can see, it's really clean, almost a whiff of smoke. I'll have another video running it a bit more, opening these pipes just to show you how clean they are. I know they're clean because I've already opened, so there is no oil on the propeller, there is no oil around here in the intake of the turbo, and there is not really that much oil around here around the intercooler. So a few things I need to say about this. So all the clamps that I've undone, all the bolts, the clamp here, the clamp there, the clamp on the underneath, I've already sprayed WD-40 on all of them overnight just to soak in WD-40 so it will be easier to open. So much easier for removal if you spray WD-40 on these clamps. So the other things for the return, the best practice is not just to undo this, see that it's weeping oil here while it's running, and then close it. The best thing is to undo the oil return down there, put it in a container like off somewhere of the engine, run it for 1 minute, and it should return at least 300 milliliters of oil. So it means that oil is coming back and it's not blocked. It's enough oil to cool the turbo. So if the banjo bolt, the first banjo bolt with the filter, if it's slightly clogged, you might want to do that with the 300 milliliters. This was really very clean, so I didn't really need to do this 300 milliliters. The other thing is, what if the turbo, if the propeller has been broken and so on? So you have to open the intercooler, clean all the pipes, clean the intercooler as well if there are any bits and pieces in there, if by any chance they have trouble. The other thing is the water pump down there. There is a very small filter, the oil that goes there, so you might want to open that. It's fairly easy. I'll probably have a video how to do that later on. Might want to open the water pump. Not the water pump, it's not a water pump, it's a vacuum pump. So you might want to clean that one as well. That's it. It's really simple. I'll have another video, because this is becoming too long already. I'll have another video, how much does it cost, how much time it takes, any other pitfalls, but it's fairly straightforward. It's not too difficult. So if you really, and it's fairly cheap to do it yourself. So if you really want to do the turbo, it's not really that difficult. Next thing is one other additional thing I forgot to say. You run it for like the engine for roughly about 30, 40, 50 miles, and then replace the oil filter, fuel filter, air filter, and of course the oil, just if there are any bits and pieces still floating around. My turbo was really good. There were no bits and pieces. It hasn't touched any of the sides, so I didn't really need to do that, but you might want to do that. So this is it. Hopefully that is useful to someone. Let me know for any comments in the comment section. Subscribe. There will be more videos coming out. Let me know for anything that I haven't really covered or have covered it poorly. Thank you very much indeed for watching. Hopefully that was useful. Thank you.